The first thought is wow, was that the midlife crisis? Closely followed by I really must get around to adjusting this suspension. Again. I've never liked the term midlife crisis. Getting old is about being wiser, more experienced than resisting juvenile peer pressure. It's not a crisis, it's just a moment of reflection and maybe one last chance to get giddy before the grandkids arrive. Except I just found myself definitely not racing on a public road with another similarly aged male rider on some kind of bright orange KTM who was also definitely not racing. For what was only about 4 miles on a particularly challenging S6B road, we were close on wheel to wheel, flicking left and right, overtaking and then re-overtaking, not making any kind of acknowledgement that the other was there, until I got lucky with some traffic and put a half-decent gap between us that he, intelligently, was not prepared to risk. Because we weren't racing. Obviously. Weirdly, the same thing happened a few months ago on an Mount 07. What is it with these dark side Yamahas? Long-term testing of motorcycles is one of my favorite things. On a press launch there are a dozen of you all riding the same machine, so it's entertaining, but there's no reference point to properly judge the performance. Once we are back in the UK you can judge a bike against the same things you always judge it against, trucks, hot hatches, many other types of bikes and sometimes, just your favorite road. The long-term bit is important because some bikes need a while to get under your skin. Or for the novelty of their showiest bits to wear off and the hidden gems appear. This encounter, as childish as it may have been, became part of the test. As close to full throttle as I've been on the Mount 09. Starting to use, and trust, the many forms of electronic assistance too. Having the bike flicking sideways, moving around, bars wagging, front lifting, back end bouncing, increasingly out of control, I really must adjust that suspension. While air intake and exhaust are making the kind of rasping noises that remind any rider why we do it. I'm not proud, but right now I don't half feel alive. That's not me, by the way. I don't do this sort of thing, usually. I am the stereotypical stealthy, calm, controlled, unflustered rider. Boring, you might say. Seriously, I don't know what came over me. Except last week the same thing happened coming home from the office on the motorway. That journey was a solo effort at being a moron. Later setting off than I expected, aiming for a time when I'd promised to be home, using the Yamaha's agility to split dawdling traffic in all kinds of the wrong lane. To an observer it looks reckless, but to the rider it's a series of well-timed, calculated flicks and snicks with minimal risk and always room to spare. Calling bikes like the Mount 09 a hooligan machine is lazy journalism that should be punishable by something I haven't thought of yet. I'm sorry. And it is perfectly possible to ride the 2021 Mount 09 sensibly and still enjoy it. The 160-mile trip on the way up to the office last week was gentle, calm, very grown up and returned 67 miles per gallon while taking no longer than most other bikes. Apart from the thinly padded seat making its presence felt after 2 hours, I was happy, comfy and reasonably refreshed. The day before my definitely not a race mentioned above, I met up with Jeff from Yamaha UK to talk me through the mount's electronics. The 2021 Mount 09 received a serious kick up the rider aids package. Based on the 6-axis IMU from Yamaha's YZF-R1 superbike. IMU stands for Inertial Measurement Unit. A device like a clever electronic gyroscope that understands how fast and how far length over your bike is and what's happening with wheel speeds and position in space. This funky gadget allows the 2021 Mount 09 to control traction control, slide control, lift control in 2 levels of ABS-basic and full-on cornering ABS-2. No one in Woking knows more about these things than Jeff. It was a fascinating conversation. Watch the video below to learn everything you need to know. It was that demonstration that gave me huge confidence in the mount's abilities to be definitely not raced like a midlife fool, which is where we came in 562 words ago. What I really like about the Yamaha though is how it swaps Mr. Responsible Easy riding for something much more antisocial in a split second. In riding mode 1, the throttle response is so direct, so sharp and so utterly flipping brilliant that all it takes is a tap down on the quick shifter, the slightest lick of a wrist, and suddenly you're very glad indeed that the earth is round, because the horizon is a lot closer than it used to be, and even your peripheral vision is focused on the flip and fast approaching point, which is the rarely discussed evil twin of the better known vanishing point. Knowing what I now know about the electronics brings a lot of extra confidence to keep the throttle open when things start looking wonky. Should I be admitting this? But that same direct engine mode is also capable of subtle, gentle motorway cruising or urban commuting with the dollop of usable overtaking power available with an instinctive twist of the wrist. Even in the wet, I still find mode 1 the easiest to control, helped no doubt by the safety net of those clever electronics. And there's been a lot of wet weather riding recently, which brutally reminds us why we all bought bikes with fairings when most of us rode motorcycles every day. Funky, naked roadsters might be cool with their minimalist and challenging styling, back to basics nature, and let's all focus on the engine attitude. But when you leave a meeting in Hartford, with 80 miles to ride home and it's chucking it down, it's only a matter of the miles before you remember how good a full fairing is at keeping the rider comfortable and their motorcycle clean. For all that saggy misery, the mount's wet weather performance is superb. It finds grip where it is needs to, has enough subtlety and the controls to still give the rider the impression that he's dancing nimbly, not plowing with some kind of clumsy tractor. The brakes are progressive, throttle response is, responsive, allowing the most gentle tweaks with absolute precision, and the water running down my neck does a good job of distracting from the hard seat, playing havoc with an aging, bony backside being pummeled by suspension that I really must get around to adjusting. That's a job for next week. In the meantime, I'll be in the shed cleaning the mount.